Perhaps I will better understand this. Actually, the issue at stake is patriotism. You must return to your world and put an end to the commies. All it takes are a few good men.
What? That nonsense is centuries behind us.
But you can't deny that you're still a dangerous, savage child race.
Most certainly I deny it. I agree we still were when humans wore costumes like that 400 years ago.
At which time you slaughtered millions in silly arguments about how to divide the resources of your little world. And 400 years before that, you were murdering each other in quarrels over tribal god images. Since then, there are no indications that humans will ever change.
But even when we wore costumes like that, we'd already started to make rapid progress.
Oh, yeah? You want to review your rapid progress? Rapid progress to where humans learn to control their military with drugs.
Sir, SickBay reports Lieutenant Torres' condition is better.
Oh, concern for one's fellow comrade. How touching.
And now a personal request, sir. Permission to clean up the bridge.
Lieutenant Worf is right, sir. Security chief, I can't just stand here and let...
Yes, you can, Lieutenant Yar.
Oh, better. And later, on finally reaching deep space, humans, of course, found enemies to fight out there, too. And to broaden those struggles, you again found allies for still more murdering. The same old story all over again.
No. The same old story is the one we're meeting now. Self-righteous life forms who are eager not to learn, but to prosecute, to judge anything they don't understand or can't tolerate.
What an interesting idea. Prosecute and judge. Suppose it turns out we understand you humans only too well.
We've no fear of what the true facts about us will reveal.
Facts about you? Splendid, splendid, Captain. You're a veritable fountain of good ideas. There are preparations to make, but when we next meet, Captain, we'll proceed exactly as you suggest.